Find it. There it is. Focus.
Press the shard. Focus.
Focus.
Use your eyes. Look.
Get closer.
What can you see? Go to it.
A king in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place.
Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. Then comes the reckoning.
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrfing.
Dillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors. and soon becomes their leader.
This way. Follow this way.
When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Touch the walls.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can see.
I can hear him.
It's too scary.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
The voice is getting louder. Listen,
Dillian. Listen, listen, listen. It's him. Listen.
It's getting louder.
There he is.
You're getting closer.
Keep going.
Send him, follow the voice.
You're nearly there.
Dillian's voice.
It's him. He's going to save you.
Find the voice.
Find him. It's not him.
It's not him.
We told you. We told you it was a trick.
Doesn't sound like Dillian anymore.
What's happening? It's not him, it can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillian.
That doesn't sound like Dillian.
It sounds like something more.
Hervor ignores her father's warnings. The grave mound opens, and it seems to be full of fire. Again, Hervor demands her inheritance, but her father warns her that the sword is cursed and would be the bane of her family. But he relents and brings her the sword. She leaves the island with it, but the curse holds true, and death would follow in the years to come. And so, Senua, the misdeeds of a father have cursed his daughter.
find another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find
another way. Think. Focus. Use your mind.
Where's he gone? He's disappeared. You need to slip through your fingers once again.
Think clearly. You have to find
another way.
There
has to be another way. It's not Dillian.
Mm-hmm.